This is a homemade constant load controller with an analog circuit made with an op amp, a MOSFET, a power resistor and a potentiometer. The Arduino is here just to read and print the values on the LCD screen. Using this device, I can simulate a load of any resistance and control the current flow from 0 up to 5.2 amps. The MOSFET is kept cool by a big heat dissipator with a cooling fan, and by doing this I can control power up to 150 watts. The precision is quite good. I can set values down to 1 milliamp of error, and the minimum value we can get is down to 0.0 something milliamps. So now I can test the efficiency of my power supply, for example. In the future, I would like to create a digital constant load device and be able to add different modes, such as constant load, constant current, constant power, and so on. But today we'll see how this analog circuit works and how I've built this device. I will also tell you what to have in mind when selecting the MOSFET, the supply voltage and the heat dissipator. So make sure that you subscribe and activate the notification bell. Consider supporting my work on Patreon. So let's get started. This episode is sponsored by the PCB manufacturer company JLC PCB. Their main services are the 2-layer PCBs for only $2. Also 4 and 6-layer PCBs, the SMT assembly process where you will get the PCBs with all the components already soldered in place, and also the SMT stencil for soldering SMT components with solder paste. The quality of the PCBs is amazing. I use their services all the time and always get good results. For only $2, you have 5 PCBs of any color that you want. So go to jlcpcb.com, upload the Gerber files of your design and order the PCBs in just a couple of minutes. What's up my friends, welcome back. In a previous video I've mounted this power supply kit. At the end of that video I wanted to get the efficiency of that supply. But to get the entire range of the current and voltage you would need different values of high power resistors. Or a better choice, a constant load controller. A constant load controller is a device that will automatically adapt its internal resistance in such a way that for a given voltage input, it will always draw the selected amount of current from that supply. There are a few ways to build a constant load controller, but today we'll see just one of the options. In a future video, I'm preparing another constant load controller that will be digital, allowing us to set a constant current value, constant resistance, constant power, and so on. But since I haven't received all the modules yet, such as the DACs or other sensors, I can't make the digital version yet. Today we'll see a very simple constant load controller. To control the amount of current is passing through the load, we will use a MOSFET, a high power resistor of 1 ohms, and an operational amplifier. To read the values I will use a 16-bit ADC and the Arduino, and to print the values I will use a common LCD like this one. To set the values I will use a 10-thirds potentiometer like this one here, and using this we can get a precision of 0.001 milliamps. So this is the final result of the PCB, and because this is just a prototype I won't make a case for it yet. Okay, so let's make a quick test to see how it works, and then I will show you how to make it and the working principle of this simple circuit. Let's say that I want to test the efficiency of my supply at 10 volts. For that I need to set the voltage at 10 volts and then to make a sweep of current values from let's say 0 to maybe 2 amps. If you have a high power potentiometer you could do just that, or maybe test separately high power resistors. I don't have a high power potentiometer, so instead I connect the power supply to my constant load controller. Using the potentiometer I set the current value to 0.1 amps. I turn on the power supply and as you can see I have 0.1 amps flowing through my load. I use the potentiometer and increase the current value to 0.3 amps, and again 0.3 amps are flowing through my load. I can do this for any value that I want that is in the range of the maximum current value of my controller. As you can see, I was able to get with this up to 5 amps, and because I have this huge cooler, the MOSFET never got hot. But the wires will get very hot, so I guess I need to use better wires. As you can see, the current value that I set on the LCD screen is the same as the current value we have on the power supply display, maybe with 1 or 2 milliamps of error. So that's how the constant load controller works. We set a current value and the device will internally adapt the load in order to have that current flow. So let's see the circuit, how it works and how to mount it. This here is the circuit I will use for this project. Let's start with the basics in order to understand better. For that I have some animations. We know that our load will be represented by a constant value power resistor and the MOSFET transistor in series with that. In my case, the resistor is of 1 ohm. We know that in case of a MOSFET transistor, the drain current is dependent on the gate source voltage. If we change the voltage between the gate and the source of the n-channel MOSFET, we also change the current flow through that transistor. This is a typical curve representation. On the y-axis we have the current flow from the drain to the source of the MOSFET, and on the x-axis we have the gate source voltage. Till we get above the threshold value or VTH, the MOSFET is in the cutoff region, and no current is flowing. Once we pass that threshold value, we start increasing the current by increasing the gate source voltage. The threshold voltage for a MOSFET is usually from 0.7 volts to 1 volt. Okay, so back to our schematic. To change the gate voltage, we could use directly a potentiometer connected to VCC, to ground, and the middle pin to the gate of the MOSFET. But using this setup, we have no information about the current value. All we do is to increase or decrease that value. If we want a feedback, we should measure the voltage drop over the 1 ohm resistor. Since this has a fixed value of 1 ohms, with each amp of current, we will have a voltage drop of 1 volt. That's basic Ohm law, where voltage equals to resistance times current. So we could read the voltage at this point here, and this will be our feedback. We then pass this feedback through a black box, and this will adapt the voltage applied to the gate of the MOSFET. This black box could be, for example, a microcontroller with a digital to analog converter, or DAC, that could change the voltage applied to the MOSFET gate till we have the desired voltage drop on the resistor. But this could also be a microcontroller with a PWM output and a low pass filter, and this could also change the voltage applied to the MOSFET gate till the feedback is the one that we want. But for today's example, I will use the analog option for this constant low controller. So to vary the voltage, I will use a potentiometer. But we have seen before that we can connect the potentiometer directly to the MOSFET gate, because in that way we have no feedback loop. So for that we add an operational amplifier in between, and this will act as a voltage follower. So we connect the voltage drop point of the resistor to the negative input, and the potentiometer to the positive input. Then the output is connected to the MOSFET gate. Remember that the op-amp will do everything possible inside, so the voltage at the negative terminal is the same as the one on the positive terminal, and that's the key for this control loop. So for example, if we apply 1 volt on the positive input, the op-amp will do all is needed in order to also have 1 volt on the negative input. But this negative input is connected to our feedback point. So just like that, by applying 1 volt here, we will also have 1 volt here as well, without having to know the voltage we apply to the MOSFET gate. The op-amp will do that for us automatically. So now we can read this voltage drop with the ADC of the Arduino and print that value on an LCD screen. If I read a voltage of 1 volt, for example, that means that 1 amp is flowing and so on, for the entire range. We can also read the voltage from the potentiometer, and that will be our set point. So that's how this circuit works. As for the op-amp, I will use the common LM324. And something to have in mind. If you supply this op-amp with 5 volts from the Arduino, have in mind that this IC can't have a rail-to-rail output, so the maximum output will be something around 3.3 or 3.5 volts. I first wanted to use the IRL3101 MOSFET, and this is why. Because the voltage I was working with was around 5 volts, the MOSFET must be a logic level 1. A logic level MOSFET means it's designed to turn fully on from the logic level of a microcontroller that usually is 4.5 or 5 volts. To know if a MOSFET is a logic level 1, just check the datasheet. If it doesn't specify it is a logic level 1, just look over the drain to source on resistance. This value is usually given at a certain gate to source voltage. If that is 4.5 or 5 volts, that usually means it is a logic level MOSFET. But anyway, we could supply the op-amp at 12 volts or so, and be able to work with other MOSFETs that are not logic level ones. So this is the final schematic for this project. You can find it below in the description, so download it and have it in front of you. To supply the Arduino, I will use a 12V DC transformer like this one. To increase the ADC precision from 10 bits that the Arduino has, I will use the ADS1115 ADC that has an I2C communication. Then to print the values, I will use this LCD screen that also has an I2C communication, so we only need two wires. The op-amp is the LM324. The potentiometer should be of at least 10 turns. If you use a 1 turn potentiometer, it will be very difficult to set the current value precisely. Finally, one of the most important parts for this project is a good heat sink. In my case, I will use a microprocessor cooler from an old PC. This also has a cooling fan, and that is even better. You see, basically all the power is dissipated by the MOSFET and the power resistor. Let's say that the input voltage is of 20 volts and that we set the current limit to 1 amp. That will create a voltage drop on the resistor of 1 volt. So according to this formula, the dissipated power on the MOSFET will be 20 volts minus 1 volt and multiplied by 1 amp and equal to 19 watts. So we must keep the MOSFET cool, otherwise it will burn out on higher power and get damaged. You can check the datasheet of your heat dissipator and see how many degrees it will dissipate and for how much power. Then you can calculate the maximum power your circuit will work with and select a good heat dissipator. Okay, so I solder everything as in the schematic on a piece of prototyping PCB. I also make sure that the MOSFET is touching the cooler. You could even add some thermo paste in order to increase the heat transfer. The cooler fan is also connected to the 12 volts input from the DC transformer. Okay, so now go below and download the Arduino code. This code is very simple, it will just read the differential voltage between the terminals of the resistor and also the voltage from the potentiometer. One will be the set value and the other one will be the real current value that is passing through the load. Now I power the DC transformer and the controller will turn on. As you can see, by rotating the potentiometer we can change the set point value, but the real value is still the same, because we haven't connected the supply at the plus and minus terminals. I set the current value to 500 milliamps. Now I set the power supply at 15 volts and connect it to the load controller. As you can see, 500 milliamps are now flowing through the load, so the controller works. By rotating the potentiometer we can increase or decrease the current value. As you can see, I can even get very low values of just 0.01 milliamps. In my case, I was able to control up to 5.2 amps, and at 15 volts that is a power of around 80 watts. The maximum current value is given by the MOSFET capabilities to create a voltage drop on the resistor, the maximum MOSFET current ratings, the heat dissipator capabilities, but also by the resistor value. If instead of the 1 ohm resistor you place two of these in parallel, so we have a resistance of 0.5 ohms for each volt instead of a current value of 1 amps, we should now have 2 amps. So by lowering the resistance value we can increase the current value. In a future version I will create a digital constant power controller. It will be more powerful, a better voltage control with a DAC, maybe it will have more MOSFETs in parallel so we could handle more current, better heat dissipator and multiple modes, so stay tuned for that. You have the schematic, the part list and more photos and the code below this video if you want to create the same device, so check the links for electronoobs.com. I hope that you have learned something new. If so, give a like to this video and consider subscribing. If you want to help my channel, consider supporting me on Patreon. So thanks again and see you later guys.